So hello and greetings to all the viewers. Today we will talk about mode superposition harmonic analysis of a bass frame using ANSYS mechanical FDM, or it is also called as ANSYS Classic. We had already undergone through model analysis of bass frame. Now what we will do, we will try to simulate the same model and we will try to apply the bass excitation in a harmonic fashion, okay, sinusoidal forces. So that we will going to apply for a particular frequency range, and then we will see the results. And that all we are going to do using ANSYS FDM. Okay, then we will start now. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. First, we will go through the problem definition, and then we will directly move towards our ANSYS learnings. So there first we will study this model analysis, then we will apply the boundary condition, loading condition, and then we will see the frequency responses. Okay. Then this slide represents the actual problem definition of our present simulation. If you see here that we need to perform the mode superposition harmonic analysis for a vertical direction bass excitation response. So suppose this is what your bass frame and this is fixed at the bottom of this. So here we will try to apply the bass excitation. So that is like 1g gravitational load at the bass excitation of the frame in vertical direction for a frequency range of 1 to 100 Hz. Okay. So it is basically the similar as when we used to do the testing by using shaker table. So there you will find such kind of excitation. So it might be like vertical on horizontal plane. So this is what one of the example of shaker table excitation, that is 1g excitation in a vertical direction. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll move towards our actual simulation part, FDL part. So there we'll try to learn how to do this mode superposition harmonic analysis. Okay, then we'll start our ANSYS part now. So this is what our actual ANSYS mechanical FDL window ANSYS parametric design language. So you will find this is what our the actual model, it may looks like this. This is base frame, and here you will going to find some sort of equipments like motor bases or your compressor base which will going to mount on this frame. And here these are like the four base portions where we will going to apply the forces. So I will further explain the model analysis. It will not going too much more time. So here like we will first apply the degrees of freedom. So you can apply by two ways. You can go here like, and here you can define the loads. But before defining this, we'll first define the solutions, right? What kind of solution we'll going to apply. So new analysis, and I will keep model analysis, right? And here analysis option. So here I will keep your number of modes need to be extract. So I will keep 10, and that blank mode extraction method blank lump coach. And here if you want elemental result also, you can keep yes. I will keep OK. I will keep this default. So we'll first see for 10 mode shape what will the frequency will going to come, right? And here if you want, you can apply loads, but I will not going to apply loads. So I will just solve as a natural frequency. I just want what we can say, we are not going to simulate the pre-stress model because there is no any loads. We'll apply that loads in a harmonic simulation. Okay, then now we can constrain this. So here you see this, you can apply displacement, and you can on nodes you can select box, and you can consider these points. 32 nodes are there, and here's the 32. So total 64 nodes. Okay, all degrees of freedom. Okay, right. So I will explain through complete GUI, not through the commands. Commands we'll do that separate session. So here if you see, we had already applied the degrees of freedom. Now we'll try to simulate, or we will directly solve this current solutions. And before solving, I will just go through the material definitions and what we had, because I am considering the same model what we considered for our see this is like your structural steel material and Poisson's ratio will be this, and there is no you can see this thing. This is model actually created in workbench and I had extracted, that's why you are able to find out this much material details, and these details are not needed as your vibration simulation. So only what we will need your like isotropic Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio. Okay, and now what I will do, I will show you the element types, and so you can see shell 80 181, and these are like their details, bending and membrane. Okay, and this is what your curved shell formulations and all these things. I had created this model in workbench and then I imported that model in this one, so that's why you are able to find this much element types and real constant details. Neither you will have only one shell 181 element type, what it will be shell 181, right? Now we'll move towards our solution part. So I will go into solve this model analysis. Yes, okay, so now if you see our read results by peak, so you will find like frequencies ranging from 1 to 120 or 125. Now our excitation is like 1 to 100 only, so for 6 mode shapes our excitation will be there. So if you want to see the plot result, counter plot nodal solution DF, so you will find next read result summary from here. Like there are 10 mode shapes we have extracted and there are natural frequencies. I think I had already discussed about what are these mode shapes and natural frequency. So we know that mode shapes are nothing but your which will represent the direction. We'll first set, you can see the first set over here, then next set, then further third set. So you will find here third subsequent and you can find the frequency 54 hertz. And if you want to animate this mode shape, so you will find like this number of frames you can create, time delays one shape, degrees of deform and deform shape, and I will keep you some. Okay, right, so it is quite slow, so you can see over here. So like that you can animate at your end also. If I want to increase the frames, next set, and I will stop this now, right? So from this window you can see the animation. By peak we'll do what we will do, we'll try to do for a 10 motion and then plot results nodal solutions. Okay, now if you want to animate for this, go to animate mode shape, you can put over here deform shape, use some I want, right, and you can increase this. So like that you can increase the speed of this. Okay, this is all about your mode shapes. Now we want to do the simulation for our harmonic analysis. So I will further call us plot. I will plot all the elements, new analysis. So we'll shift to the modal superposition analysis, that is harmonic. And here from analysis option, you can do mode superposition. So there are different options like full and mode superposition. So I will going to use mode superposition, and this is what your lump masses approximation, like it will show real as well as imaginary. I think we had already gone through these things, and I will keep this by default. Once it is done, you can go to low step option, and here time and frequency region is there. So here you can define the frequency. In our problem definition, it is from 1 to 100, right? And for this, I want number of substep like 10 substeps. I want to solve in the steps. Okay, Okay, now we'll apply that loads, define apply. Here go to inertia, gravity, global. So we will apply on a global, so it will going to apply on the constant locations and global node set. And I will keep it is 1g, so it means like 9.81. I will keep it vertical direction, so it will be on z direction. Okay. So your accelerations you can see in vertical directions. And if you have any components, so you can define that component and you can apply over that component also. Right? And so right now our loads are only this one. So I will going to solve for this. Apply and load station frequency is done. Now if you have any damping, so you can define like 0.02%. I'm keeping constant damping ratio, right? And for that we will try to solve this simulation. Okay, yes, it will not going to take much more time because it is quite simpler one. So for this acceleration level we had already solved the simulation. And if you want to see by peak, you can see this number of your cumulative load states 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10 and even substates also. And this is what your first load state. So I want to read respect to like 6-1. Read this close. And for that, if you want to see the deformations, so you just see the total deformation, what the deformation will be, right? Suppose if you we have applied in y direction, so we'll see the y direction deformation 1180. So like that you can perform the harmonic simulation. But here now I'm interested to see the stresses. So here you can see the equivalent stresses. See here the warning it is showing that the requested S data is not available. So it means that we still solve the simulation but we haven't expanded the solution mode shapes. So for that we need to expand. So I will further show you the error. Suppose I want X component stress. So you can see this S data we need to request. So you should always keep in mind when you are going to solve the simulation by using FADL. So in that case, so you can go to further analysis option. Here expansion pass option is there. So here you need to expand the modes. Okay, so I will keep on. Okay, now what I will do, I will go to load step option, here expansion pass and the range of solutions. So I will keep all boards to expand. Okay, and here calculate the element result, yes. Okay, so once it is done, you just further solve or you can expand the solve. So now I will go to solution further and I will solve this current LS. So now if you see, it will show us our modes, it will going to expand. So you can see here, right? It is now into the expansion mode of this your respective mode shapes. So it will take some time. So here what is the solution is doing, like it is using that the model analysis mode shape and adding that mode shape with this our saturation forces so that it will give us a combined response. So that is, it is called as a modal superposition harmonic analysis. Okay, now our solution is done. I will close this, I will close this window further. Now if you want to see the stresses, nodal solution stress, we will see the equivalent stresses, right? So now you can see the stress values, right? So like that, you can see over here stress values. Now if I want something like stress intensity or even I want to see X direction stresses, so you can see what will be the X direction stress. And if you want for frequency, this is like you can see here the step 1, sub step 10, frequency 100. I will go into use by peak. So now you can see over here up to the frequency 10 you will find this number of substrates that we have added. tag for this respective group. So you can see over here. Now one substep 7 and frequency will be like this. Now from this you will get some idea at what frequency what will the stress values. Right, I will read this. Now you can see your stresses are changing. Now you can easily see the stress levels, and from that you can come to know whether my base frame is failing or not. You just put your yield limit and you can compare with that. So now I want the response in terms of some graphical and at respect to node. So what we will do, we'll go to this time history post processing, right? And here I will first delete this which I had already created, and here now delete this. From this you can add a response, and you can see the your displacement response. Like we had applied excitation in Y, so I will keep Y displacement, and here you can define your variable name. So I will keep OK, and I will seek the respective node where I want to see the response. I want to see at this particular node. I will keep OK. So you will find over here the response for that respective node, right? And this is what your node number, Y displacement, this is minimum and this is your maximum. And if you want to see the particular graph for this, so you can plot this. So accordingly you can see how it is varying. Like this is what your graph, which shows that frequency versus your value, and at 10 frequency it is like 0.75 and gradually it is increasing, and at the 60 frequency it is fake. So from you can easily figure out, so the maximum response like 2.5 and the frequency of 60, and what the load we have applied, that is 9.81. similarly, I want to add furthermore the response in x direction. Okay, I will plot elements further, and I will similarly find the node. Okay, and I will plot for that respect node. So you can find our x direction response, right? So here it is like 1.6 maximum, and similarly I want to see the response further in z direction. I will keep okay. I think we had applied in z direction excitation, not in y. So might be here we will have some more response. Plot elements. I will keep this element. Okay, so you can find over here, and similarly the response for this, if I am not wrong, it is maximum, right? Because we have excitation, applied excitation in this direction, 5. Similarly, if you want to see the response j direction at any particular node at the down frame, zoom to fit. I want to see the response at this point. I'll keep this node, select that node, okay, and I will plot for that node, right? So you'll find the different graph levels, right? Here it is at 80 frequency the response is higher, and in previous we had seen at here also you can see the 80, but at this respective node you will find somewhere we had seen at 60, right? Yes, 60. So like that 60, 70, 80, these are like critical frequency where we are getting higher responses for the respective displacement. So like that you can figure out how to see the response. Okay, so that's all from my side. And if you want to see, suppose there are some forces which I need to apply, consider one of the example, like here some excitation forces we need to apply, that is due to your vibration shaker. Suppose this is shaking from this side, so how to do that? I'll just explain how to apply the forces. Here you can define load apply structural, and here you can apply these forces on nodes, right? So you can select that respective nodes like this, okay? And for that node you can define the values. So you will find like that. And once your values are defined, you can define from this load step option time frequency. Here you can define time fee, and here analysis option, let me first select harmonic. Once your model analysis is done, you can apply this in harmonic, then it will show load step option and here frequency. So similarly, you can define whatever your frequency, like 5 to 100, like that. And here number of substep, if you want you can define, or if you don't want you can keep it, right? So like that you can define. Here also you can define the damping. So similarly, other than forces, whatever the loads are there, structural, like displacement, pressure, inertia, so that you can apply by using this harmonic simulation. Okay, so thank you guys, thank you. Let me know your comments, I will be there to help you. Okay, bye bye, take care.